organizing FDP on product design and prototype development. It's a good sign that we want faculty members and research scholars from varied backgrounds. We want them to learn with us and to contribute something somewhere with interdisciplinary research in the growth of nation, in the growth of state. And let me tell you about the Engineering College Bikaner. It was established in 1999. It's a young, budding engineering college of 21 years of age. And it was opened in autonomous mode by the government of Rajasthan. This is the largest, or say, as an infrastructure and faculty-wise, the biggest engineering college in the Rajasthan, who has achieved many milestones within the 21 years of its inception. Raudhasar and was taking efforts for the innovation, product designing, and prototype development. He has also developed some prototypes along with his colleagues in the department of EIC. So many initiatives have been taken in Engineering College Bikaner regarding startups, incubation centers, product designing, and we are having many BTech courses, and recently opened BTech courses in automation and robotics. Last year we have opened BTech courses in artificial intelligence and data science. So we are also running with the future needs. We also want to provide the technical knowledge to the budding engineers in the field of emerging areas, which has been provided by the AICT. And with these words, I would like to welcome all the participants who has come from all over the India to make this happen. Without you, without participation, any program cannot be fulfilled successfully. So once again, thanks to the AICT Atal Academy and organizer Raudhasar and Harjit ji for getting this kind of sanction from AICT. Thank you very much.
These details were informative. Thank you, Manoj Pudi sir. The motivating academic and research environment is assured by our head of the institution, Dr. J.P. Bhamu sir. His active administration has brought our institution as one of the best technical institution of Rajasthan government. I request Principal Dr. J.P. Bhamu sir for few words to inspire organizers as well as participants. Please, sir.
Thank you, Vinod. First of all, charan spras to my guru, Rajinder Karwa sir, guided us in a better way. That's why today we are at this practical platform. So my charan spras to you, sir. And without guru, we cannot success in our life. So this is the foremost thing. Now the second person who is basically leading our Bikaner Technical University. When I spoke on day one to our honorable vice chancellor Vidyarthi ji, he spoke about the innovation. He spoke about the the center of excellence. So sir, I welcome you, and I regard your thought, your vision, and definitely your under your leadership, this particular institute will grow in a better way, not only in Rajasthan but in India in times to come. My special thanks to Rahul Raji, who is always a passionate person to innovate something, innovate in terms of the product, innovate in terms of the services. So Rahul Raji, you are great, and your team also very great, because I am seeing from last couple of years that continuously when AIC department, in enrollment in the AIC department is going down, you and your team has taken the lead. And definitely from last year when I saw almost all the seats filled, this shows the commitment for this too. So I respect your commitment and hope that this journey of commitment will continue in times to come. The persons behind this FDP, the head of the department of AIC, Harjit ji, Raulaj ji, Vinod ji, because all we are here, the eminent speaker, the eminent party, the personalities, the chief guest and the guest of honor, they all are here because of you. So I respect this particular thing that you have taken the initiatives to organize such type of event. Sir, with due respect, I want to tell, then we have to think in a out of the box, because sometimes we are comparing ourselves with China is basically exporting. China has 12% of export in all our world. and we have only 1.2% in that particular the business. So if you want to increase the business, we have to go for the innovation. And what type of innovation? We have to see that particular product development, the manufacturing sector has to be improved. So this can be achieved only by seeing that in what way we can develop some product which can help to the environment, which can help to the society, which can help in overall growth of the business. So for all the things, from the consumer point of view, from the customer point of view, we have to think that in what way the cost can be reduced, the delivery faster delivery can be ensured, and of course the quality of the product. So all these three parameters, quality, cost, and the delivery, we have to think, we have to produce that particular supply chain system. We have to innovate that particular supply system that will enhance the overall business of the country. You see, there is a 60% contribution from the MSMEs, and they are lacking the product design and in the field of the product design and development field. So ours is the responsibility. We are the technocrats. We have to think that in what way we can strengthen those MSMEs in a better way. How we can provide the the consultancy in terms of the product, in terms of the services, so that their businesses can be enhanced and their overall the improvement can be ensured. So of course, it's a big challenge in front of us that in what way we can provide our services, our expertise, being an academician, being a researcher to the society, to the industries. It's a daunting task, but of course we have to see and in what way we can enhance these activities. Because by 2027, we require 10 crore jobs. 10 crore young people will enter into the market. How we can fulfill expectation from those young minds? That is a daunting task. So somewhere we have to keep the balance. Somewhere we have to increase the manufacturing sector. Because most of the the labor that is presently also they have in the involvement in the agriculture sector. So somewhere we have to shift our that particular focus from agriculture to manufacturing sector. So definitely the deliberation from this faculty development program will enhance something from industry point of view, from business point of view, from overall growth of the country. So definitely I expect lot of deliberations from this FDP, and sure at the particular platform after 5 days we will be in a position to have something in our hand that can be achievable. So again I welcome the guest, and I place on record thanks to the organizers and especially the participants that they shown the interest in this particular thing. Thank you Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.
Thank you, Principal Sir, for your valuable words. We have Professor R.K. Karwa with us. He is an eminent professor specialized in machine design and thermal engineering. Professor Rajendra Karwa received his Bachelor of Engineering degree in Mechanical Engineering from University of Jodhpur in 1973 and Masters of Engineering in Mechanical Engineering specialized in thermal engineering with honors from the same university. He obtained his PhD in 1998 from IIT Roorkee. He retired from MBM Engineering College, Faculty of Engineering and Architecture, Jnanan Vyas University, Jodhpur in 2012 as Professor and Head, Department of Mechanical Engineering after service of more than 30 years. He worked as visiting faculty in Addis Ababa University, Addis in Ethiopia from 2003 to 2005. He served as Director Academics at Jodhpur Institute of Engineering and Technology from 2012 to 2020. He has published about 70 research papers, 22 of them are published in journals. The Google Scholar citations of his publications are more than 1,380. He has authored 4 books and edited 1 conference proceedings. He has 37 years of teaching experience and has supervised 15 research scholars. He has also successfully executed a large number of industrial projects. His area of interest are machine design, heat transfer, solar thermal applications, and energy analysis. Having his detailed this introduction ceremony, however, I would him for giving few motivational words for this FDP. Please, sir.
Dr. Rahul, should I start now? Sir, presentation will start after this inauguration. This is we want to have some few words, blessing words.
Okay. Respected Honorable Vice Chancellor, Professor Vidyasi, Professor Damu, Professor Rahul Chaudhary, Vinod Yadav, and other dignitaries and participants, teachers and students. It is always my great pleasure to interact with the engineers, especially the faculty of engineering, because ultimately the driving force for economics is the engineering. You cannot think of development, job creation, without engineering applications. And the need of the hour is not only to save the environment, but to provide cheaper products to majority of our population. Probably as of today also, almost 70% of the people, especially in India, are deprived of some basic facilities. So we have to develop the products which are within the reach of the poorest of the poor. And this is how we can uplift their life. To make them able to purchase the products, we have to provide the employment. And in agriculture, already 50 or 55% people are against, but they are also facing great hardship due to some wrong policies of our successive government, I would say. But anyhow, for remaining, you know that a large number of youth are migrating from the villages to the cities in search of the jobs. And maximum jobs are being provided by the engineers. Industrial development, medium scale industries, cottage industries, you have to develop the products which are cost optimized, which give a very reliable performance. I do not agree with this today's philosophy that use and throw the product. There was a time, I am talking about my childhood, we used to say that Dada Khride Pota Bhatte. Dada Khride Pota Bhatte means a product which has been purchased must serve at least for 30 to 50 years. And today's technology is that to purchase a car, after 3 years, sells the car. And so you are creating a large number of, a very huge volume of wastage, and the control of the wastage, and more products, luxury products you are producing, more pollution, you are adding to the pollution. And the one scientist said, he rightly said that this living world on the earth is going to end not due to any pandemic, not due to any strike from outer space, but due to your luxuries only. You will destroy the environment and that will kill you. And this human race will be this earth because of your luxury only. So we should, the engineers, we should think. Of course, we cannot stop it because it creates probably a very revolutionary economic change is required. But that is a different point. That is not point here. But as in general, what we can do is we can provide cheaper products, reliable products, products which serve for a long time. You don't think of the rich or the upper middle class, which is having a trip psychology. You think of just 60% poor people. When they purchase any good, any product, they want that this should serve them at least for two generations. So you have to think about good products, but cheap products. I used to give one example in a class that what is important, you just understand. Suppose you make a slight improvement in the design and that saves 100 rupees per motorcycle. Only 100 rupees, a slight modification. You have 10 days effort and you are making a slight modification and that saves only 100 rupees on one motorcycle. India is producing 1 crore motorcycles per year. So you are saving 100 crore rupees of our country. Now you just think the people who are just struggling for bread, how what these 100 crore rupees can do for these people. And this is the power of engineering. So you as engineers should always think that how I can make a product more reliable, more cost effective, less polluting, and that is real engineering. Your research effort should be always directed towards this action. Don't think of developing a cheaper process which can produce wallpaper, which can produce very costly cars costing 2 crore rupees. I just always get annoyed when I read the news that some people are purchasing car for 2 crore rupees or 50 lakhs rupees or 1 crore rupees. In what direction you are thinking? Just people have, you have seen during the pandemic that lakhs of labors from Rajasthan and Delhi were moving on foot to its UPUPR. And one side we have such people, and on the other side we are thinking of purchasing a car of 1 crore rupees. Why we should have 7-star hotels or 5-star hotels? Jitne dharmshalaye bani hai, wo sari built only. There's a time in my life I have seen, I have stayed in dharmshala. There was no problem. Why we should have very good hotels when people are not getting even the hut to live? People are sleeping on the footpath. So what, as engineers, we can revolutionize, we can completely change this world if we can develop cheaper products. And how the cheaper products can be developed, it is all engineer design decisions. If you are injected fundamental knowledge, then you can always think what are the parameters which control the design, performance, as well as its cost. Most important part, whenever I have taught, I told you that think of the parameters. Think of the parameters which control the cost and performance of the design, and then try to optimize that. Engineering is optimization, not making a product only. Product to jugaad bhi banta hai. The bullock cart and the food cart, aapne dekha hai. सैकड़ों सालों तक, हजारों सालों तक दुनिया को सर्व किया है. देयर वाज अ टाइम इन 1975, आई स्टिल रिमेंबर द न्यूज़ इन टाइम्स ऑफ इंडिया दैट मोर गुड्स आर ट्रांसपोर्टेड एट द टाइम 1975, आई एम टाइपिंग ऑफ 1975, मोर गुड्स आर ट्रांसपोर्टेड बाय बुलेट कार्स देन द ट्रक्स. सो दे हैव सर्वड फॉर थाउजेंड्स ऑफ इयर्स, बट नाउ व्हाट हैज हैपेंड, बट नाउ वी आर थिंकिंग ऑफ very heavy pollution inside the city. Why we should have loading taxis? Why not bullock carts? I was traveling in a train. I used to do such type of thing that I deliberately took a passenger train from Jaipur to Jodhpur just to see how the people, very poor people, are thinking about our society and what are the problems. तो थोड़ा हिंदी में बताऊंगा. एक आदमी चढ़ा बकरी लेके उसके अंदर, तो मैंने इसे पूछा बकरी कितने की आई भाई. ये बात होगी करीब अराउंड 2006 or 2007 की, 5000 की बकरी. मैंने कहा क्या बात कर रहे हो, 5000 की बकरी तो गाय तो फिर 1 लाख की होती होगी. क्यों नहीं साहब, वो अकाल वर्ष था, गाय तो 2000 रुपये मिल जाती है. मैंने कहा तुम मजाक कर रहे हो कि नहीं सर, ये बकरी है 5000 की है, गाय 2000 रुपये की है. मैंने कहा व्हाट इज द प्रॉब्लम, क्या है व्हाट इज द प्रॉब्लम. उसने कहा सर गाय के बछड़ा हो जाए तो क्या करें, उसका बैलगाड़िया तो है नहीं, क्या करें उस बछड़े का, और हिंदू होने की वजह से उसको कटने के लिए बेच नहीं सकते, तो गाय गाय कैसे पाले गाय. लेकिन बकरी का जो बच्चा होगा, और ये लाल बकरी है, लाल बकरी का जो बच्चा होता है वो कटने में जाता है, इसको एक पर्टिकुलर फॉर्म है, वो बड़े पैसे देके खरीदती है लाल होने के, इसका बच्चा लाल ही होगा और उसकी भी अच्छी पोस्ट मिलती है, तो हम बकरी पालते हैं, गाय क्यों पालेंगे. यू वी डोंट फॉर सिटिंग इन द सिटीज, वी हु आर एक्चुअली रिच और अपर मिडिल क्लास, वी डू नॉट नो व्हाट आर द प्रॉब्लम्स ऑफ द विलेजेस, एंड वी आर थिंकिंग ऑफ डेवलपमेंट. लोडिंग टैक्स से बना दी सर, बड़ी फास्ट चलती है, 15 मिनट में सामान आ गया. अरे क्या दुनिया पहले हो जाता है क्या, अगर सामान एक घंटे में आ जाता है तो बुलेट कार के ऊपर. व्हाट इज द थिंकिंग एरिया, वी आर कैन नॉट चेंज, वी कैन नॉट चेंज द होल इकोनॉमिक, दिस इज बट एज इंजीनियर्स इफ वी कैन डेवलप, देयर आर 3 simple principles. You should know what are the alternatives, how you can product, how can you develop a product which is cheap and good performing, and how it is impacting the environment. if you can take care, I am always of the strong principle, as of today, we cannot reduce the pollution, total pollution. But we can reduce the rate of increase of the pollution. And in that, we as engineers can contribute. And this is always you should have this in mind. Gandhi ji kaha karte the, Gandhi ji ko ek bar Mazandar Chibita ne pucha ki main koi kaam kar raha hoon to mere upar se pata chale ki ye सही है ये गलत है। तो उन्होंने कहा कि आपने किसी गरीब को देखा होगा ना, तो आप ये सोचिए कि इस काम को करने से उस गरीब को, गरीब का क्या भला होने वाला है। अगर आपको लगे कि उसका भला हो सकता है तो वो काम एकदम सही है, गरीब संबंध है, आप उसको कर सकते हैं। तो वी इंजीनियर्स शुड ऑलवेज थिंक दैट द रिसर्च विच आई एम डूइंग, द प्रोडक्ट विच आई एम डेवलपिंग, that the lessons we are giving to the students, whether it is going to help the society, the poorest of the poor of our society, and how it is going to save our environment, save the materials, reduce the wastage which is being produced, then you are successful teacher and successful engineer. These are the words I would like to say. Then last one important thing I would say, that we are the luckiest one that we got the opportunity to become engineer. Don't think that it is due to your caliber only. The society as a whole, not only your parents, society as a whole has contributed something to make you engineer. Now when you have to become engineer, if you think that it is only due to my capabilities that I am engineer and I have every right to enjoy all the luxuries of this world, and why should I think about the poor who are not working properly, who are not being educated, they are not sincere in education. So I think is this type of psychology we have, we are not. I am always very, very thankful to the whole society, the poorest of the poor, who is when he is purchasing oil from the market, he is paying some tax. And that tax is utilized by MBM Engineering College, where when I was a student, I paid only 300 rupees yearly fees. How can I forget? अगर MBM इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज में सस्ती एजुकेशन नहीं होती तो मैं गारंटी के साथ में कहता हूँ मैं बीकॉम करता और किसी जगह तलरखता, किसी प्राइवेट कंसर्न में या गवर्नमेंट में तलरख का काम कर रहा होता। इट इज ओनली बिकॉज ऑफ द MBM इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज एंड नियरली फ्री एजुकेशन दैट आई वॉज एबल टू बिकम एन इंजीनियर एंड देन आई एडोप्टेड टीचिंग एंड फ्रॉम माई साइड with my best effort I have tried to contribute to the knowledge of the engineering and impart my knowledge. Whenever I give my lecture, I give from heart, not only from mind, and I want to contribute the maximum to the knowledge. And I think ki maine is dharti ka rain utara hai, aur ye main aap sab engineers aur students se request karunga ki is dharti ka keval aapke parivar ka nahi, आपके समाज का नहीं, कि आप बनिए है तो बनिए समाज का भला करेंगे, करिए उनका भला, लेकिन जो जितने गरीब है, जो पुअर है, जिनको रोटी भी नहीं मिलती, उनको हमेशा ध्यान में रखिए। एंड वी कैन नॉट डू डायरेक्टली एनी हेल्प, एंड आई एम नॉट इन फेवर दैट यू शुड गो टू सम कॉलोनी पुअर, सम कॉलोनी ऑफ पुअर पीपल, एंड वन फाइन मॉर्निंग आउट ऑफ 365 डेज इनटू टू टाइम्स मील दे रिक्वायर, एक दिन आप जाकर वहां पे 10 किलो अनाज देके आ जाते हैं, नाउ यू फील दैट यू हैव डन द सर्विस ऑफ द सोसाइटी। नो, देयर आर 365 डेज, 80 इयर्स एज, टू टाइम्स फूड एंड अदर थिंग्स आर रिक्वायर्ड बाय देम, एंड दिस कैन बी कंट्रीब्यूटेड ओनली इफ योर टैक्स मनी इज प्रॉपर्ली यूटिलाइज्ड बाय द गवर्नमेंट टू प्रोवाइड द फैसिलिटीज फर्स्ट टू दोज पुअर एंड देन टू अदर सेक्शन ऑफ द सोसाइटी। एंड एज इंजीनियर्स व्हाट वी कैन डू इन दिस रेस्पेक्ट वी शुड ऑलवेज थिंक ऑफ। Thank you for patience hearing. I think I have taken too much time and gone somewhat beyond the main aim of the FDP. Thank you for patience hearing, and I am very grateful to the organizers of the FDP to give me this opportunity to interact with the engineers of engineers, that is the teacher of the engineering colleges, who polish the students to become very good eminent engineers and serve the society. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Professor Karwa sir. for your valuable motivation. It was really very impactful speech. We are fortunate that our Vice Chancellor has spared his valuable time for this MDP.
We are thankful to Honorable Vice Chancellor. Probably he may likely be, must be a very busy person. And it is a great thing that he has spared some time to be with us and engage us that the program is having a great importance in the university's outlook also, and that is a great thing. We want such type of vice chancellor who promote academic activity that takes interaction between the teachers and engineers. Thank you, sir, very much. Thank you, sir.
Professor Amrish Saran Vidyarthi is presently the Vice Chancellor, Bikaner Technical University, Bikaner, since 4th May 2021. Prior to his current appointment, sir has served as the Director of Government Engineering College, Nanhipari Simant Engineering Institute, Pithoragarh, Uttarakhand, and Institute of Engineering and Technology, Lucknow, Uttar Pradesh. Professor Vidyarthi is credited with the creation of a world-class research and teaching infrastructure at Birla Institute of Technology, Mirsra, Ranchi, where he served from 2003 to 2014. Professor Vidyarthi has made significant contributions in the area of industrial and environmental biotechnology, food biotechnology, cancer biotechnology, computational biology, and bioinformatics, and completed more than 10 sponsored R&D projects. Professor Vidyarthi has supervised 25 PhDs, 67 PG dissertations, and published over 275 research publications in peer-reviewed journals and symposia. He holds 2 patents out of 6 filed in Indian process patents on production of various biomolecules. Professor Vidyarthi also gained expertise in value additions to waste materials during his stay at Institut National de la Recherche Scientific University of Quebec, Canada, from 1999 to 2002. Dr. Vidyarthi is the member of Biotechnology Advisory Committee of Jharkhand State Biotechnology Board, and nominated member of Task Force to various union ministries. Dr. Vidyarthi is elected Fellow of the Institution of Engineers India and Institution of Electronics and Telecommunication Engineers India, and is a member of Indian Society for Technical Education, that is ISTE, Biotech Research Society of India, that is BRSI, and Association of Microbiologists of India. Professor Vidyarthi, in the coming years, wishes to position the Bikaner Technical University one amongst the India's topmost technical universities, with focus on building core research competency, developing world-class teaching programs, nurture translational research, and encourage innovation for wider impact on society. I would request him to say his blessing words for organizers and participants. Please, sir.
Thank you for nice introduction. Honorable Professor Rajendra Karbaji, my colleague Dr. Jay Prakash Dhamu, Rahul, and Harpreet, and all other organizers, you know, the team of this very important programs, the faculty members of various institutions associated with the Bikaner Technical Universities, and dear participants. First of all, I express my extreme, the thankfulness to the organizer to giving me such an opportunity to speak on the text. Actually, this is the, I think, first core engineering, the FDP, faculty development programs. Why I said the first of the core problems and providing the solution, as the, the being engineers, it is our first duty to, after studying so many, subjects and, doing a lot of experimentation, it is the first time where we have to go for the product design. Now, the product design is, as Dr. Rajendra was, mentioning, it's a very complex problem, and it requires a lot of thinking process before coming to the preliminary design of the product. You have a lot of attributes is required to understand the requirement of the product. And the same time, this product has to be very cost effective, green in nature, that's causing less pollution, and then the sustainability. Most of the people, while we are designing the product, we forget about the sustainability. Our product, if it's a very, of good quality, even if it's lacks the attributes like the cost effectiveness and the relevance to the need of relevance to the need of the society, as well as the availability and in the delivery times should be very, very small. Because say for example, today we are facing a problem of COVID pandemic, right? Here most of the the institution will come out with a supply of the oxygen, and I'm fortunate that our this college has come out with a solution to provide the oxygen concentrator in a very short time and in mid of this crisis. So if we can go for those kind of the product design, definitely it will be very helpful to the society at large, as society is looking from the engineer itself, as we say that we are the creator. So we are created in the two form. One is the good human being or resource, and another is the solution of the existing problem. Now the second thing of this the FTP is the prototype development. Now even if your design is good enough and it causing a number of the problems, a number of the the attributes which are good enough, and it's a perfect design, but if you are not able to make the prototype and you cannot translate it in a product which is a very competitive and cost effective and providing the the faster solution with the accuracy and sensitivity, that product design does not have any significance. So the both the the topic which are clubbed together, and they are interrelated, basically the design as well as the prototype development. Now we have a lot of engineering solutions available and processes are available where we can translate it, our project design in a prototyping and the product development. So basically, like the 3D printing has come out since it has a really great significance in such a way that we can design atom by atom and the face by face. So actually we don't have those kind of the tools available, and that's why the engineering product design was a really cumbersome job for an engineer to come up with this. So I congratulate the organizers of this important activity, which has direct relevance and direct relevance to the engineering education, research, innovation, and the product development, as the people have a young mind which is very good in theoretical knowledge, but they cannot produce the products. So it's a very good thing. And I just want to mention a small thing, as Professor Rajendra was telling about the small innovations integrated in the existing products, which can save the cost. I was working in Indian Institute of Engineering and Technology, Lucknow. One person from Devaria, of Uttar Pradesh, his academic background was only 10 plus 2. And rather 10th was the, he has passed the 10th examination, but he was not able to continue and get the 10 plus 2 degree. He came up with a solution of engineering problem. He has told, the name was, I think, Vivek Patel. And you might have, you know, heard his innovation. And what he did, he has, you know, design a disc and you know, couple you know, the motorcycle and enhance the, you know, he has small bit changes on the nozzle itself, and by this way the he has claimed that his motorcycle you know, the efficiency, fuel efficiency of his motorcycle was enhanced from you know, 60 kilometer per liter to 200 you know, kilometer per liter. That was the really great. And when this proposal has been sent to Council of Science and Technology, you know, the CST, better known of UP, and they have forwarded this problem and to, for the assessment of this solution to me. And that time we have started seeing the back to the engineering, you know, the problem and the solution what he has proposed. We find that this was, you know, pushing the air, you know, in around 30 to 40% more. So total combustion was, you know, enhanced. And by this way, we were expecting that 30 to 40% of the fuel efficiency can really be, you know, enhanced by this action. When then we start cultivating those by making those kind of, you know, we were very much concerned about the, you know, the torque, because initially if it is you know, going very very fast, then what happens, it may have certain problem of continuation, or once the, you know, the vehicle is stopped, then to start with, that would be the major issues. So then we have conducted number of experiments with NIT Allahabad. Professor R.K. Srivastava was there that time. He is now no more with us because, you know, last year he has taken the last patent. But because of this, then we have gone for the patenting of this solution. And then we have also approached to start. And I'm happy to, you know, tell you, announce at this point of time that the government of India has given around 10 crores, you know, mentioned the 10 crores rupees for the, you know, seeing the design of the vehicle and amount of this. He has made number of, you know, the articles in newspaper, and he has shown his product in various exhibition. And we were very happy that though it was a initial, you know, the opportunity is given by the CST to me, but I put the honest efforts to connect him with a good institution, with a good professor, and then finally he has, you know, come out with a, this kind of the grants as well as the product development. And he has already, you know, modified the bike around more than 200 bikes, and the people were appreciating and giving the feedback that really that works. So I appreciate Professor Rajinji that he has telling that this kind of, or rather he is very much keen to, you know, to inspire all of us that if we can take a small you know, slight modification, okay, which has which are jo hai improving the design or the products by say 10% or 15% or 20%, that would be a good you know, the contribution for all of us, because if you are saving the resources, that would be good enough. I will also jo hai, you know, appreciate the point at the points that before going for the, you know, the product design, we should think of the lighter in the weight of the product, and the same time the material should be taken, you know, which can be a composite material that can be prepared out of the waste, or it's useless for the, you know, the for the society or the environment. And if we can club together, this will be definitely, you know, enhance our capabilities, and we can testify that yes, if we can do those kind of the products and the lighter in their weight and the in efficiency, that would be really great, and that is the you know, the need of the us also. So I basically congratulate all the organizers and the participants also that they are learned and inspired to make their own design of a product which they can think of and making the product development and the prototype developments. So thank you very much for giving me an opportunity to interact with you young mind on a you know, a very relevant engineering problems. Thank you very much. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Honorable Vice Chancellor, sir, for giving us motivational words. Now I request Head of the Department of Electronic Instrumentation and Control Engineering, Professor Harjit Singh, sir, for his valuable words and vote of thanks. Please, sir.
Honorable Vice Chancellor, sir, eminent professors and invited experts for the technical session today. Principal Professor J. Prakash Bahu, sir, Registrar of Engineering College, Bikaner, Manoj Puri, sir, coordinator for this DP, Dr. Rao Chaudhary, sir, participants and guests. A very good morning to everyone. It is my proud privilege to propose the vote of thanks for the 5 days at LFDP starting from today, organized by Department of EINC. From the core of my heart, I would like to express my gratitude and heartfelt thanks to Honorable Vice Chancellor, sir, for gracing this occasion and enlightening us with his words of wisdom. Thank you, sir, for sparing time, for guiding us from a very busy, hectic schedule, for being present with us on this FDP of national importance. Thank you, sir, for guiding us on sustainability, relevance, faster process of products, 3D printing, use of waste, and other things, with the technical details also. Your words will be guiding us always, sir. Now I thank experts and speakers who have joined us, Professor Karwa, sir, for the first session. Also, I thank Principal, sir, for his always support and encouragement at every step. Also, thank Registrar, sir, Manoj Puri, sir, who is always a crisis manager for us, helping us at every step. I also thank the coordinator, Dr. Rao Chaudhary, sir, for taking initiative and taking this responsibility, and also the chairman AACT and the AACT for entrusting us with this FDP of national importance. I also thank participants and support staff, without which this would not be successful. Participants have shown their enthusiasm and they have registered in large number. I wish them very good FDP learning for the next 5 days. Thank you once again. Thank you all.
Thank you, Harjit sir, Professor Karwa sir, Dr. Rahul Chaudhary sir, Vice Chancellor sir, Principal sir, Manoj Puri sir, and other guests for their gracious presence in this inauguration ceremony. Now we will formally start our program, and I would like to invite Professor Karwa sir for his expert talk. Please, sir.
I'll interrupt. Bhamu sir, now this inauguration session is over, and we are thankful to Vice Chancellor sir and all the administrative officers. So I think will we start this session?
Yeah, you start. There is no problem. But unfortunately, I will join on the way because I am going to the college. So sir, I will take the permission that on the way I can join you through mobile only. Okay, so my best wishes to the organizers, and thank you once again, Vice Chancellor sir and Rajendra sir. Thank you. Okay, yes. Please start.
Sir, you can present your presentation now. You can share your presentation.
Okay, I am just trying to share it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Am I audible to you?
Yes.
Sir, I think Rajan sir has logged in from two devices. So the echo is coming from the other one. Because in the participation,
yes, sir.
Did you put it out?
Yes.
We have come to the next slide.
Yes, sir. Sir, थोड़ा volume भी आप तेज कर दीजिए, कोई दिक्कत नहीं होगा.
Pardon?
आप सर वॉल्यूम
अभी ठीक है बिल्कुल सर
वॉल्यूम बढ़ाऊं वॉल्यूम इंक्रीज करूं क्या
नहीं ठीक है अब सही है सर नाउ इट इज ओके
ओके ओके यू कैन सी माय स्लाइड
यस
ओके व्हेनेवर यू आर थिंकिंग ऑफ डेवलपिंग एनी न्यू प्रोडक्ट फर्स्ट यू हैव टू सी व्हाट इज द नीड सो यू हैव टू डिफाइन द नीड along with constraints. Now, the constraints, there can be many type of constraints, just like cost, then the size, the available materials, available processes to manufacture it, etc. I will discuss them whenever I will discuss the product. Then identify the possible solutions. What are the possible solutions? I give very simple example which can be understood by any engineer. Let's suppose the problem is that you have defined the problem that the room temperature is very high. So the problem is that you have to cool it. Now the alternatives available are that you redesign the room with such material that temperature of the room is in control. You provide some evaporating cooling method, say desert cooler. You can have an air conditioner. So these are the possible solutions. So whenever you have a problem which has been well defined along with the constraints, identify the possible solutions. And then just to start with, you select judiciously one possible solution which is to be analyzed critically. It may be possible that your decision is not correct and that you will have to restart with another solution. Anyhow, you have selected one solution and you start from there. Then you have to, I am giving some examples of designs. That will be because I am basically a person of design. So I cannot give any other example. But I give some examples and I will like to and try my best to present in such a way that all of the engineers who are sitting here will be able to understand it. So, the most after defining the need and selecting one particular solution, which in your opinion that it can be the possible best solution. Okay, now go for the design. Design from mechanical engineering point of view is carrying out the engineering analysis. Even if it is problem of electrical engineering or electronics engineering, you will have to do the engineering analysis. That is an important part. When we talk of any product design, you have to include the selection of material also during the engineering analysis. Because if you have selected a wrong material or if you have not selected the material, then it may be possible that the analysis which you are doing will not be in correct direction. How it can be, I will see later on when I will discuss the design.
then optimize the design based on certain criteria. You have to fix certain criteria. Without criterion, there cannot be any optimization. And for that, you have to include the manufacturing constraints also. You are developing a product in a particular company or factory, and if you have not seen what are the manufacturing constraints there, then you may come out with solutions which from which the product cannot be developed. So you have to very clearly see what are the manufacturing constraints of our organization, our country, or the whole world. Okay, so optimize the design based on certain criteria. I will discuss the criteria in detail. Then manufacture the prototype. Next part. Once it has been optimized, a design is there. Then you have to manufacture the prototype. Because while designing the product, you have discussed with the production engineer, you have discussed with the material science engineers. Then definitely, you will find that not much difficulties are there. But still, manufacture the product. And you have, I have shown here by arrow, that while manufacturing the product, the production engineers may feel certain difficulty with the certain design parameters which you have specified on the product. Then you will have to rethink and redesign it. So it is feedback nature. Okay. Then during the manufacturing also, the production engineer may point out towards certain problems with the it, and you may have to go for engineering analysis again. So it is all of feedback nature. The information from the next stage goes push you to back to the previous stage or stages, and you will have to redesign. Then, once the prototype has been made satisfactorily, the production engineer has been able to produce the product as per the requirement of designer. Designer will have to see after development of the prototype that it has been developed as per his recommendations. If it has been properly developed, then it goes for the test of the product prototype. Just like suppose a mechanical tension test is to be carried out, or you have to test to see the efficiency of the motor. Then just like that, I have given some example. You have to see what is the running temperature of the transformer. These are the all the type of tests which you have carried out. Then you will launch the product. While launching a new product, you have to be always think that the field conditions may be different from your laboratory conditions. So the product which is successful in laboratory may create certain problems in the actual use in the field. So you field trials will start, and you will have to take feedback from the customer, and again you will have to go back. To which stage I can't say. You may have to come here or here, and then again test it again. Go to the customer, launch the product, have the feedback, and this is what we call as development part. Designing, prototype manufacturing or development, and then the real field trials and development part. Just you take this example of this reaction. What has been said that it is for emergency use. Why it is called for emergency use? Because the test results are from the laboratory, not from the field trial. Now, in the field trials are going, you are giving the vaccination, you will have the reports, you feedback from the patients, and then you will find that, okay, in field such are problems are there, then it will go back to the company which is manufacturing the vaccine, and then they have to modify it. Or they have to specify what are the parameters which you have to control so that there are no side effects, etc. This is how the whole process develops. Okay, now going to the next slide. Now I talk of the optimization criteria. This is very important part. Without this, you cannot develop any optimized design or design which will satisfy the customer. The following are the usual optimization criteria, not necessarily it is covering all aspects. As engineer, because you know about the requirement of the customer, you are from a particular engineering stream, so you may find that some certain other criteria is there. Just like, for example, when you are developing a mobile, the audio or video clarity can be important criteria. So it is from mechanical engineering point of view, or well, you can say very, very generalized point of view. Cost In 90% cases, cost is always the optimization criteria, but there are other conditions, just like performance. Of course, cost may be reduced, but not at the cost of performance. So certain minimum performance guarantee you have to give. Just like when you are purchasing motorcycle, he says that it is 60 kilometer per hour in ideal conditions. So this is the minimum performance guarantee which is there. It may be possible that your motorcycle is actually giving 70 kilometers. But if it is giving less than 60 kilometers, then complaint from the customer will be there and your design will not be accepted. You will have to redesign it. Then the criteria can be low cost. This is particularly for aviation applications where low weight, low weight is important. Then reliability. There are certain applications where 99.99% reliability is required, just like aviation industry, nuclear power plants. So there are certain field of application where the very high reliability is required. Now the question is that when you have properly designed, when you have tested the prototype, you have some field trial data also. Despite that, why this reliability point is coming? Because there are uncertainties always involved in certain part of the product development and design. What are these uncertainties? I am sorry to say that 95% of engineers do not know what are uncertainties involved with their product. So it is very important to understand the uncertainties. Just like I am giving some examples, you have made certain simplifying assumptions in calculation of loads, etc. While doing engineering analysis, you know that all engineering analysis is not so simple mathematics that 2 plus 2 is always 4. There is no uncertainty here. But this work for mechanical engineering, thermal engineering, you know that when you are analyzing any thermal system, you say that, this parameter has very low effect, so we can neglect it. Okay, we can assume that viscosity is constant, it doesn't vary with the temperature, or variation is very small. Such type of simplifying assumptions are always there whenever you are designing or doing the calculations. So these are uncertainties involved. Now, I give one very typical example for mechanical engineers that you have heard the name of Nusselt's correlation for condensation. It was derived, the equation was derived mathematically, very nice. Nusselt was given a huge credit for that. But when it was carried out, experiments were carried out, they found that it was giving results with 25% error. And these uncertainties were due to assumptions which were made by Nusselt in his analysis. So similar, whenever electronics engineer or mechanical engineer, they are making certain assumptions, then load to which the part may be subjected in actual application. You took the example of cycle. It is produced. Now, when it is running on the Indian roads, there may be huge pits. Then if cycle at high speed is going into a pit, what type of dynamic force it is coming? It is very difficult for the design engineer to predict this. So there is uncertainty. Okay. Then uncertainty regarding the material quality. You are taking material from Tata Steel. You are taking material from some other company. Tata Steel material has greater reliability, but don't think that it is having 100% reliability. The reliability of the Tata Steel material may be 99%, but even 1% uncertainty is there. Then during the manufacturing process, some stresses are introduced. Some flaws are there. Not in all pieces. 1 out of 1,000 pieces or 5 out of 100 pieces. Any uncertainty in the manufacturing process, during the manufacturing process, some defects may be there. So these are the uncertainties. And for a designer, for product development engineer, it is very difficult for him to, it is not possible that you can test all the products. You are manufacturing 10,000 products daily, 10,000 components daily. It is not impossible that you will test all the components. You will have some certain sampling testing that you will test 5% or 1%. And 1% is giving satisfactory result. You will assume that a complete load is good. But this may not be possible. That there may be, even then, there may be 1 or 2% products which have more manufacturing flaws than possible. So higher the desired reliability, better is the cost of the material. So sure, you have to strike a balance between the reliability and cost. If you go for higher reliability, you will have to go for better quality material, more intensive testing, you know, better granulations, and that this is all time consuming and cost involved is there. So you have to make a balance between the reliability and cost. But an engineer, design engineer must know that what is the importance of the reliability. Then sometimes you go for compact design. Just like take example of automobile. Here the complete mechanism inside is having space constraint, so a compact design is required. How a compact design is possible, I will discuss later on. Then space constraints may be there. Compact design is space constraint, they are very close to each other. Sometimes the compact design is done simply by changing a material and saving the cost. So cost may be the consideration. But space constraint is certainly another thing. You have to fit a certain thing to any particular space. So accordingly, you will have to select the material or manufacturing processes so that space constraint is satisfied. Then aesthetic sense, it is important. If you have to, because ultimately, you have to attract the customers. So if aesthetic sense is not there, if it is not looking good, then it is not going to, you will not be able to sell it. So however, there are certain requirements where you cannot make any compromise, just like strength. Whatever will be the optimization criteria, I have not given here, because the strength is to be there, or the minimum performance guarantee is there. You will not decide an electric motor which will burn after 10 days or 20 days. You cannot. So you cannot design, you cannot make compromise in a design in certain factors. So in the case of, in the slides to follow, I will explain the optimizers by taking certain examples. So the example may be from engineering, mechanical engineering point of view, but other engineers can also understand it. Suppose the need, I am coming first to the need. There is a need that you have to join two walls. There is a need that you require a prime mover, just like an electric motor of so much power and so much RPM. Then taking again to the mechanical example, so you have to design two circular cross section road. The load is 30 kilonewton, which is of nature varying from tensile to compressive. In both directions it is acting, but the infrequent variation of load is there. Low number of load cycles are there. This is how you have to define the load clearly. If incomplete definition of load is there, you cannot design. Then constraint. Constraint is facility you require. You have to join two roads with the facility of easy assembly and disassembly is desired. This is complete definition of the problem, load, constraints, and the need. Now the selection by mechanical engineer, there are three, four types of different joints are there, and you have decided that a quarter joint will be suitable one here. Now manufacturing constraint you will see, you will have to interact with the production engineer. Okay, what are the manufacturing facilities you are available? Definitely you will ask, what the type of manufacturing facilities would you require? So you will spell out that, okay, casting, forging, rolling, etc. I require such type of facility. Then he will say, okay, I have forging and upsetting facility. So for developing the quarter joint, which you have selected as a solution, a typical solution, forging and upsetting are available. And from engineering point of view, these are the best one. So you are going. Then material available, you will have to again ask the production engineer what materials are available in our store. You will see it is cast iron and plain carbon steel, only no alloy steel. Plain carbon steel, carbon 0.2 to 0.4%. These are the two materials available. So you will have to select one of the materials out of here. Okay. Then how many number of pieces are required? A few in numbers or large in numbers. Accordingly, everything is decided. Whether you should go for automation or the products will be manufactured on a lathe, milling machine, etc. by the labor, expert labor, skilled labor, or you will go for automation. If you have to make products in millions or thousands, you will go for automation. If you have to develop on 10, 20 or 50 products only, then you will have to go for simple machines and you will have to depend on the skilled labor. Then suppose the design decision is that, okay, first the first alternative, I will try low carbon steel. Now see, the alternative, it is very important. For engineers, I am talking time and again, what are the possible solutions, what are the alternatives which are available with you. So regarding the material, you have the plain carbon steel 0.2%, 0.3%, 0.35%, 0.4%. because the low carbon is the cheapest one and easy to make the product. Processing is very simple, very easy. So you have selected that I will go for low carbon steel. Your selection, remember that the design is of feedback nature. You, by going to the last system, you may have written to the first system and redesign it. This is the typical nature of the design, whether it is electronics engineering, mechanical engineering, or electrical engineering. So you have selected as a first trial low carbon steel. Okay, and you have recommended the process that it will be upsetting process followed by machining. Okay, I go to the next slide. So, for mechanical engineers, it is the quarter joint showing all the dimensions. For other engineers, just think that this is the machine component which you are designing. Okay, now this is the road diameter. This is one of the roads, this is another road, and the road diameter is D. And these two roads are to be joined by this particular component, which is mechanical engineering known as quarter joint. For usual proportions are given that if in emergency you have no time to derive, you can rely on these proportions which are available in handbooks, which are available in codes. If you see BIS code, you will find that these proportions are given. Standard textbooks, the proportions are given. So if you have no time, if you want one or two pieces, there is no need of wasting time 1 month or 2 months in designing. You can rely on usual these proportions. So you see that you just find out the road diameter, which is simply in tension or compression. A very simple 2 minutes formula is there. You find out the diameter of the road. Once the diameter of the road is known, all the dimensions of the quarter joint are known to you by probability, usual proportions. But remember that usual proportions do not give always the optimized solution. It is one viable solution. It is just like bullock cart, which has served thousands of engineers, is not optimized solution. It is a solution which is workable, which has worked, which has served, but not an optimum one. Okay, so if you use usual proportions, you will have a product which is serviceable, which will fulfill your requirements, but not in an optimum way. So how it is? I just see it. Your design analysis, you have selected the material, factor of safety. Now this is another decision where engineer has to take, whether it is mechanical engineering or electrical engineering, you have to keep some factor of safety. So here a high factor of safety based on yield stress has been taken. And why this high factor of safety? Probably in design, the most difficult part is to select the factor of safety. And sometimes we design engineers say that it is factor of ignorance, because you have the not complete information or the information is not there. You are very uncertain, so you are going for a high factor of safety. Really, it is a very difficult decision. After 5 years service in field, you find that not a single case of failure has been reported. Then you can think of reducing the factor of safety and giving a cheaper product. This is how the sometimes development may continue for years together after field trials. So here, the designer has taken a decision, the factor of safety will be 3.5. Why high factor of safety? Because of reversal of the load. Now you find out the tensile stress, shear stress, and then find out the road diameter. Use the usual proportions. You have all the dimensions. So a workable design is there. Now we go for optimized design. Now you do the what we call as strength analysis, because all dimensions are known to you. So there are different various modes of failure. And the interesting thing about this particular element is that a large number of modes of failure are there. There are 12 modes of failure. One was basic, that is road diameter. So remaining 11 modes are there. With these proportions and load known to you, you have find out that in different modes, this could be the strength, which we call as strength or resistance. Which must be greater than or equal to the external load. So I have given the values here. Again, on the next slide. Now, you see that the external load was 30 kilonewton. Because mechanical engineers know that during the assembly, you have to push the portal inside by hammering it. Now, we do not know how much assembly stress will be there. So you have to again, some assumption is there that 25% extra load will be there due to this initial assembly stress or load. So design load you have taken as 37.5 kiloNewton. As far as the basic load is concerned, 30 kiloNewton outside load. And you see that the component has been designed by using the user proportions. And you can see all of the in different modes, in all 12 modes, the strength is greater than 30,000 Newton. So it is workable solution, but still risk is there that if assembly stress is too much, failure may occur. No, but that is second design. The important thing that you see that these four strengths, modes in these four modes, the strength is less than the design load. So you will have to be very careful during assembly that too much hemorrhage will not be there. Okay, you can tolerate it for time being. But you see this mode, your strength requirement is 37.5 kiloNewton, just approximation, and strength is 60,000 Newton. In this mode, again 40,000 Newton, 60,000, 43,000, 56,000, 49,000. Is it a good design? Optimized design? No, it is not optimized design. I give very simple example which can be understood by any layman. A chain consists of 100 links. A chain consists of 100 links. And one link is very weak. All links are having strength of 1,000 Newton. But one link is having a strength of 800 Newton. What is the strength of the whole chain? It is 800 Newton. Because if you apply a load greater than 800 Newton, then that particular link will fail. Now, what is the sense of using 99 other links of greater strength? It is shear stress. You can optimize it. If load is 100 Newton, you make that the weakest one of 1,000 Newton. But remaining link should also be ideally should be of 1,000 Newton. If any link is having strength, say 1,200 Newton, it is the strength of material. So the best, what is optimized design? Optimized design is that in all modes of failure, the components should have equal strength, and that is the optimum design. But remember that, just in an elective circuit, you optimize it, but you have to keep one component weak, just having strength equal to the external load. So if overloading is there, that component will fail, and this failure will have the minimum damage to the component. So taking example of elective circuit, you provide the fuse. So if overloading is there, heavy current is flowing, the fuse will blow up. And then we will not damage to the system. So similarly, in this quarter joint, the cheapest component is the quarter. So if overloading is there, the quarter should bend. And once it will bend, the joint will be loose, and you will say the joint has failed. So you can change the quarter. So you have to make all equally strength at all modes. The weakest will be the quarter, because it is the cheapest element which can be changed. So I have tried by modifying the dimensions, and now you see that different modes are having these strengths, and still there are 1, 2, 3 modes which are having greater strength, much better than earlier one design, but it is still optimized. Now the question is that a component is having 12 different dimensions, 12 modes of failure, and by hand calculation, how difficult it is to make it such that it has equal strength on all modes of failure. That's why computer program is required. Manually, you will have the fatigue, and either you will not attempt another alternative, or you will start making mistakes. That's why in design, it is essential that you develop the computer program. It is not available. And once computer program is there, you can readily change the dimensions and find out the optimum solution. Now, how much computational time is required, that will depend on your skill. That if you are finding that in particular mode, strength is too much, then you should know which component's dimension is to be reduced, so that its strength is reduced, but other modes are not affected. It is a really very intelligent process for the designer to do the optimization. So computers are available there, and it is not such a simple problem. It is really a very intelligent activity to carry out the optimization. Now I give one another example, and I think most of the mechanical engineers think that the design of the lever is probably one of the simplest problem on machine design. I say no, it is not so simple. You go in depth and you will find that it is very interesting. You see that these are the limited cross sections which are used. Those who are not mechanical engineers, there is some simply say that there is certain component for which there are four alternative sections which can be used: circular, elliptical, rectangular, and I sections. Now, what are the specialty? Circular, easily available. Those are available in the market. You purchase any size, make the component, very simple solution. Then if it is elliptical, either you will have to go for forging or casting, so you will have to make a decision. First, whether circular or elliptical, then forging or casting, no, it is very not very simple. Then you have another solution, rectangular one, readily available in the market. So it can be better solution than elliptical, not necessarily. Yeah. You see that I will show the error in this direction. Those who are mechanical and civil engineers, they know that the lever is subjected to bending for mechanical engineers. For civil engineers, simply you think that the lever is there is a component which is subjected to bending. And in bending, we know that I section is the best one. But it is very difficult to fabricate I one. So I section is the best one. But the way to fabricate it for mechanical engineering, if it is metals, it is forging. Forging is a difficult process. Why? It is costly process, because a forged machine is very costly affair. Although component will be of very good strength, but forging itself is a costly process. So if you want to produce large number of components, you can go for forging. A few number of products, now the competition is between the elliptical and rectangular. Those who are from mechanical engineering and civil engineering, they know that this is the best section, this is the worst one. Now, this you have to produce a few number of components, you cannot go for I section. So the choice is between rectangular and elliptical sections. Civil and mechanical engineers know that this is a moment of inertia will be more than that, this elliptical section. So you will have to go for rectangular sections, which is readily available in the market. But sometimes it may be not possible that you are not getting the right cross section, then you will may have to go for elliptical. The good thing about elliptical is that you can make it, if you are making casting process, you can think of elliptical. It can be made by forging. So with this discussion, you can very well think that how difficult for engineers to make a decision. So it is all prepared nature. You will think of one thing, we'll go to the last stage, do the cost analysis, do the product testing, and then you will have to come back. No, elliptical decision was not good, and I should go for I section. But sometimes, if you can take correct, there are certain constraints and information available with you, and you can make very good decisions. You see, I have given five examples. One lever loaded safety valve. You see, this is the lever, and it is of uniform cross section or rectangular cross section. Very simple. You take any plate of, it may be possible that this strip is available. This strip is available with you, and you have to make the bosses for the fulcrum and the lever pin. And for that, you know that a greater boss length is required. So you just put one solid cylinder here, weld it, and then make a hole for the pin or the fulcrum. And it will be manufactured. Few components if you have to manufacture. If large number of components have to be manufactured, you may go for forging or casting. If casting is there, you will not go for rectangular cross section. You will use elliptical cross section, because some components of rectangular cross section cannot be casted properly. You see this lever. Now, due to this typical shape, you cannot manufacture it from simple plate. Taper is required. Then you see that this is plate in this direction, this is plate in this direction, this is plate in that direction. Of course, you can manufacture with this plate welded here, this plate welded here, this plate welded here, and making the bosses if you have to make three components. Now, the basic load is bending load. Again, as is usual levers, you will have to find out what is the load. Is it steady? If it is low number of cycles, 10 raised to 3 or less. If it is 10 raised to 3 to 10 raised to 5, the factor of safety must be increased. If it is fatigue loading, if the number of loading cycles are more than 10 raised to 6, cutting loading is there, and you will have to go out for simple welded design, but you will have to go for forced frost level. Then coming to the next slide, this is rocker arm, which is used to open the valve in the engines. And we know that it runs at a very high speed, where very large number of cycles are there. If it is 1500 RPM for the stroke engine, valve is to be opened 750 times per minute. You see during the life of the engine, how many number of cycles, billions of cycles will be there. So the loading is fatigue loading. Lightness is important because it helps to move and return to its original position. Again, move upwards, move downwards. So it should be light so that the initial forces are less. So subjected to fatigue loading, lightweight, and the high lightweight. So you will have to go for medium carbon steel or alloy steel. And I section will be give the lightest possible lever. So you will have to make it by forging. You see that according to application and requirement, you have to make a decision regarding the manufacturing and materials also. As far as designer, simple designer is concerned, he is concerned with the loading and I section. But that is not a design engineer, and you cannot make optimum design until unless you cannot decide regarding the material which you will use and the process which you will have to use. So it is not possible that a designer will be very good in material selection or knowledge of the materials, how they will be heat treated, what will be their own properties. You cannot be. So you will have to discuss with the material science engineer while designing. And then regarding the forging process or manufacturing process, you cannot be expert. So you will have to discuss with the production engineer also. So you see that the designer's work is most difficult one. And I used to say, Hindi mein bataunga main kehta hu, hamesha class mein kehta tha, jab design padhata tha, ki maa ek aurat ki purnata maa banne mein hai. Ek aurat purn jab hoti hai, jab wo maa ban sakti hai, aur ek offspring ko janam de sakti hai. To ek engineer ki purnata tab hai, जब वो डिजाइन करके जो प्रोडक्ट दे सकता है, क्यों डिजाइन नहीं प्रोडक्ट दे सकता है, तो इंजीनियर तो असल में इंजीनियर जो डिजाइन करके प्रोडक्ट बना सकता है वो कंप्लीट इंजीनियरिंग है. सो यू हैव टू बी कंप्लीट इंजीनियर एंड फॉर दैट आई एम टॉकिंग दैट नॉट अबाउट द प्रोफेसर्स जस्ट लाइक आई एम अ पर्सन ऑफ डिजाइन सो आई कैन नॉट बी वेरी गुड इन मैन्युफैक्चरिंग और मटेरियल सिलेक्शन बट आई स्टिल हैव सफिशिएंट नॉलेज टू मेक अ डिसीजन. And then I have discussion with the production engineer. That is very important. So I used to say that the most difficult part in the product manufacturing or product delivering to the customer is designer's work. So the designer have to take decision according to the, these are the all constraints that this component is subjected to fatigue loading. Because of inertia forces, you have to keep it light. These are the constraints. So while designing any product, you have to see the constraints. Then you see this crank, the cranking of the engine. You have to start the engine with the help of a crank. Now its loading is not only bending but torsion. This is the engineer, design engineer, any design engineer who knows the strength of materials properly, which he must know. The design engineer must be perfect in the strength of materials analysis. If he is not, he cannot be designed engineer. So combined loading not a big problem. In frequent occasion, only sometimes you have to start the engine, say 2, 3, 4, or 5 times in a day. So the number of cycles are not large. It is only problem with my cast iron. The question is why cast iron? It's exclusively. I have not written any other material. Because of this complicated set, this is actually the crank. Up to here, this is the crank. This is the crank part. Because of this complicated shape, it is very difficult. And as you see, its size is quite big. It is very, very difficult to produce it by forging. It is very costly affair. Very costly affair. So you will have to go for cast iron. And when it is cast iron, the whole thinking of designing will be changed because cast iron is very poor in bending. Cast iron is good in gushing, wearing, but is not good in bending and torsion, and accordingly, you will have to select the factor of safety and you will have to design. You see how difficult it is. Now, casting is the method because of a complicated shape. I go to the next very important thing. Here, I will not discuss this spanner. This is spanner, you use it. Now, the loading is bending, shearing, crushing. in vacant occupation, sometimes you are injured. Material will be because of heavy load and lightness is required because the space constraint also, medium carbon steel or alloy steel. I section invariably because of lightness and forging invariably. You have seen on the spanner, it is written drop post, means it has been made a drop hammer forging machine. Okay, now the question is, can I make this spanner from a simple plate? This is plate of thickness. What is thickness? This thickness required. This I section maximum thickness required. I take a plate and cut it like this. Will this spanner be good? No. Because a rolled steel sheet has fibers in this orientation. So if you cut the sheet to make the spanner, you see that this fiber, if I take this example of this fiber is going up to here and not connected to the whole body of the spanner. So there is possibility that failure will occur here, way here, or any here like this. If I go for casting, there is no orientation of the fibers. It is uniformly distributed, again it is weak. But if I go for forging, I have given the typical fiber orientation. In forging, you see that all fibers are going to the whole body of the spanner. So when you are putting a load, I have shown the load here, when you are putting a load here, no fiber is just having a small length or not supported by other fibers. This fiber, even the first fiber, second fiber, any fiber is going to the depth of the body. So it will have the greatest strength. And this gives, this particular example gives us indication that what is the importance of the forging process in designing. Then I go to the next example, selection of design of drives. Rahul, I would like to continue for half an hour more. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, good. Because I started late. I started at 10:05. Now, the selection of the drives. This is the first most difficult part for a design engineer. To transfer, what is the need? To transmit a known amount of power from given driver and given machine are given. Driver is given, say, an electric motor or an engine, a turbine, any driver is there. Driven machine, it may be a lathe machine, it may be a pump, cursor. So any driven machine is there. And what the RPM of the motor or engine, RPM of the driven machine required RPM, may be variable RPM. Maybe I don't know you. This is the problem definition. Now, loading, you will have to find out what type of load is there. Steady load, minor shocks. If minor shocks are there, you can create in mechanical engineering steady load. Medium shocks of two heavy shocks. There may be medium shocks, heavy shocks. You will have to find out according to the nature of the driver and driven machine. If driver is, say, engine and driven machine is centrifugal pump, or blower, blower load is steady. But engine output is not steady, it is variable. So wherever power stroke is there, a shock is there. Now engine is four stroke engine or single stroke engine. If single stroke engine is there, more shocks are there. If it is four stroke, if it is four cylinder engine, less strokes will be, less shocks will be there. If the driven machine is, say, a reciprocating pump, then wherever compression stroke will come, the load will increase. Then during the success, the load is reduced to almost zero value. If it is crusher, then whenever crusher's downwind strike, the very heavy stroke will come. So you have to study the characteristics of driver and driven machine. You see that, how interesting it is, designer's work. So very interesting, very interesting. Then intermittent operation, you want to operate the machine for 3 hours. In two shifts, 8 to 16 hours. In continuous running, 16 to 24 hours, that is known as continuous running. If continuous running is there, you have very less time to inspect the machine, whether it is all components are in the correct shape, looking to be correct shape. And then oiling can be very difficult to do the oiling in between, or very difficult to clean it in between. So if continuous operation is there, you will have to go for a high factor of safety. If two shifts are there, then one shift is available for maintenance. If it is intermittent operation, then you can assume it to be steady load. Then space constraint. Suppose you have to make a compact design, the space is very small. You will have to go for gear design, gear drive. If large space is there, I take चक्की पे गए हो क्या ना? ठीक है ना? एक plate bed सत्ता का कि लंबी distance पे, है ना? 10 feet की distance पे space is not a constraint. Safety requirement. If you are using the belt, if all loading is there, belt will start slipping. So there is no chance of damage of the driver or driven machine. But if you are using the gears, and I'll take an example. You are running a lathe machine using gears. An electric motor is driving the lathe machine using the gears. Take this example. Now, due to foolishness of the labor, semi-skilled labor, he has taken too much depth of the cut. Rough cut is there, and the depth taken is too much. His speed is quite good. A very heavy load will come over it. Suppose it is being driven by a 5 kilowatt motor. Now the load is coming as 10, requirement is 10 kilowatt or 12 kilowatt. Motor is not able to give it. But the gears are there, they may be able to transmit it. So what will happen? Either the tune will be broken, or the gear will be spoiled, that will be broken, or the gears will fail, or the motor will burn out. So what should be done? A safety element must be there. So if we put a belt drive in between, then wherever loading will be there, then belt will start slipping. So you cannot put a load more than 5 kilowatt because the belt is there. Belt is safety element in between. Just like in electric circuit, the fuse is the safety element. So if you drive to overload and some circuit is there, the fuse will blow off. So this is the decision that designer has to make while making the design. Then material availability, definitely you will have to see it. I will discuss it later on. Manufacturing capabilities, what you have. The availability of standard elements, sometimes standard elements are required, whether they are available or not. Availability of skilled labor, noise consideration. Why it is noise consideration is important? You know that V-belt is less noisy. If you use plastic gear, nylon gears, there will be no noise. In audio machines, plastic gears are used, there will be no rules. But if you are using castor gears with a skid lubrication, more noise will be there. If you are using a flat belt with a joint, then you know that whenever the joint will come in contact with the pulley, there will be noise cut. Then another will be cut. This rhythm is there, noise is there. So you have to consider the noise. Okay? Then cost. Although it is last point, but it is always the first point in most of the products. Now, what are the types of drives? Belt, plated V, chain drive, gear drive. In gear also, four types of drives are there. So, people, what are the possible solutions? There are 4 plus 2 plus 6 and 7 solutions are there. So, for this problem, we have 7 solutions. And from all considerations I have discussed, you have to make a choice of it. Because you see how important the designer's decision is there. So suppose, as a trial, the designer has decided that what is this particular application, you are going to use spur gearing. Okay? Let us try it. Okay? Now design of spur gearing. It is for mechanical engineers, but other engineers can follow it. When you are designing a component, machine component, you have to see, you should know, what are the possible modes of failure? Those who are no mechanical engineer, they know that the gear tooth can fail in 3 modes, bending of the tooth, then fatigue failure, uprooting of the tooth. I have shown here, with passage of time, when fatigue loading is there. But what is fatigue loading? When number of cycles are more than 10 raised to 6 loading cycles. And more than 10 raised to 6, then a fatigue crack may develop, it is not properly designed. This crack will proceed further with passage of time. And ultimately, the crack will complete and this tooth will be uprooted. That is known as fatigue failure, uprooting of the tooth due to fatigue fracture. Then surface fatigue may be there. You know, those are mechanical engineers, that during the meshing of the tooth, first the tooth, meshing tooth, will rub in on the surface in this direction while engaging, and while disengaging, it will move in the opposite direction. So you are pushing the surface with a heavy foot. Any pressure, first in one direction and then in the other direction. And whenever such reversal of load is there, fatigue failure occurs. Now, where this reversal of load is taking place during the rubbing, it is on the surface. So actually surface putting is there. So there are three important modes of failure for which we have to design. Then normal wear is there, which is always will be there. And the gear cannot run forever. With passage of time, normal wear will be there. Normal wear is nothing abnormal. Slowly its size of the tooth will come down. It will be reduced. And after 10, 15 or 20 years, it will be weak and you will have to redesign it. Now coming to the first mode of failure. We know that mechanical engineers, that this is the equation which is taking care of the first mode of failure, that is bending of the tooth. Those who are not mechanical engineers, they simply take it as a mathematical problem. There is a mathematical problem that if this is the external load and this is the strength of the component, which is function of, it looks 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 parameters are there. Pi is not a parameter. So this load carrying capacity of the tooth is function of 5 parameters. What are these parameters? It's not much concern of other engineers. For mechanical engineers, they know what are these parameters. Anyhow, well, now see the alternatives. What is design stress? Sigma t. Now, there is no list of gear material. Whenever you are selecting material to design free strength and design stress, first you have to select the material. Now, you see the alternatives. There is a long list of gear material. If you see the gear material in a handbook, quality handbook, you will find that there are 30, 40, 50 types of materials available. From cast iron, medium carbon steel, alloy steels of different type, then non-ferrous metals, bronze, low coefficient of friction specialty is there. In bronze, and different classes are there. Then if you have plastics, I have already talked low noise. So you will have to decide a material. Not necessarily that your decision is correct. You will have, if you have certain thing in mind, but okay, this material can do, this material can also do. You will have to start with one material. Design it, find out the cost. Try another material, again design it, find out the cost. You see that so much analysis can one carry out with the hand. That's why computer program is required. So the mechanical engineer should be very good in computer programming. He should be able to develop its program if he is not having a standard program available in the market. For design, some programs may be available, but for all designs, you cannot have the computer programs. So you will have to develop your own program. So you see, in the first parameter, there are large number of alternatives are there. Then this factor is known as, those who are mechanical engineers, they know this is known as velocity factor. And it is a function of, it is due to dynamic loading. Dynamic load means any load which is where time is the factor. If I hammer anything, it is dynamic load. If load is varying, changing with time, it is dynamic load. Dynamic means time factor is there. Now it depends on which line velocity, at what velocity the gear is running. Which line velocity means gear is just like a circular disc. So what is the periphery velocity, that is known as pitch line velocity. It depends on pitch line velocity and quality of gear. Again, when we talk of quality of gear, four qualities of gears are available in the industry. Those who are mechanical engineers, they know it. Those who are not mechanical engineers, they should simply know that for this parameter CV, there are four types of quality of gears available. So many alternatives here, then four alternatives here, then a form factor. This normally factor, why is known as form factor? It is function of pressure, angle, and number of feet. So this y is function of 2 millimeters. No more. It is phi. Is having 3 values, 14.5, 50, 25. So 3 here and 1 here. So you have 4 parameters, 4 alternatives. 4 parameters, 4 alternatives are there. Then, if you want to go for compact design, a compact design is generally a cost-effective design. Normally, not necessarily. Sometimes a cost-effective design may be other one. But if you have a compact design, then definitely it may be cost effective. So you see that those who are mechanical engineers, they know that 14.5 degree, 20 degree, and 25 degree pressure signals are used. Now, minimum number of teeth of the PDL is 32 in case of 14.5 degree, 17 in the, that is number of teeth of the gear. Other engineers can also understand because they must have seen the gear. So greater the number of teeth at the gear, bigger will be the size. If you go for 25 degree, it will be 11 teeth only. So if you compare 14.5 degree and 25 degree, it is 11 teeth minimum, this is 32 teeth. So median will be 3 times bigger. So should we always go for 25 degree? 90%, I would say, yes, we always go for 25 degree. And those who are mechanical engineers and teaching design, they would say, sir, 25 degree is not used. No, I told you, I tell you then that in textbooks, it is not available. But now this is being supplied with the gears or 25 degree pressure angle. Unfortunately, in textbooks which are available in the market or end goods, no data is available for 25 degree. So generally, those who are teaching design, they go for 20 degree pressure angle and minimum number of teeth at 70. Okay, so you will see that in designing and bending only, large number of alternatives are available. Now I go to the next slide. Then, I told you that second mode of failure is fatigue failure. This is fatigue load equation. In this load equation itself, you can see how many parameters are there. V, the pitch line velocity. C, a vector known as dynamic load stress vector. Then the beam width, width of the tooth. Then the external load. This is not in your control. The variation of V is in a very small range. So, not much scope. I will discuss it later on. Important factor is the dynamic factor or load stress factor. Now, this dynamic factor is function of the error in gearing action, the actual error in gearing action. Then, Young's modulus of elasticity of the material. Again, C is function of two parameters. Dynamic load is function of four parameters, and C is function of two parameters. Rather, you can say three parameters. If opinion and gear materials are different, then there will be three parameters. Now, the most difficult thing here is, what is this error? Error in gearing action. No machine part can be produced with zero error. Sans product may be there. It is possible that you are produced 1,000 gears. And when you find out that one gear is having no error, it is sans error. सभी औरतें हेमावाली भी नहीं हो सकती उसको मैं हमेशा हंसता हूँ क्लास के अंदर कि वो चांस से एरर है भगवान तो सब प्रोडक्ट एरर के साथ ही बनाते हैं लेकिन वो जीरो एरर के साथ ही आ गई तो वो हीरोइन बन गई ठीक है ना सो अदरवाइज भगवान भी परफेक्ट नहीं है भगवान भी एरर के साथ ही बनाते हैं मैंने तो 5 फुट 4 इंच का बना दिया और राहुल को 6 फुट का बना दिया मैं 20 किलो से ज्यादा वजन नहीं उठा सकता एक आदमी वो 100 किलो उठा लेता है एक बहुत जोर से दौड़ सकता है एक नहीं दौड़ सकता कोई काला है कोई गोरा है हा? किसी की आंखें छोटी किसी की मोटी तो भगवान भी परफेक्ट नहीं बना सकता नो मशीन कैन प्रोड्यूस परफेक्ट कंपोनेंट विद जीरो एरर सो यू हैव टू टॉलरेट सम एरर सो दिस इज प्रोबेबल एरर व्हाई इट इज कॉल्ड प्रोबेबल एरर आई विल डिस्कस लेट यू सी फर्स्ट यू हैव टू सी व्हाट इज द परमिसिबल एरर फर्स्ट यू हैव सी दैट यू हैव टू टॉलरेट सम एरर एज डिजाइनर You know that you cannot produce the product with zero error. So you will have to allow some error. Now, lower the error, greater will be the cost of production. So you will permit the maximum possible error so that will give the cheapest. This is how the decisions are to be made by the design engineer. So suppose the velocity, pitch line velocity is 5 meters per second. The maximum error as per the recommendations of the designer's handbook. The maximum error you can give is 0.064 mm. So you should try to select the process of manufacturing such that the error is equal to or lower than this. You cannot give more than this error. Otherwise, dynamic loading will be too much and fatigue failure will be there. So first, according to the pitch line velocity, the designer has to decide how much maximum error he can permit. Remember that first principle is that no part can be produced without error. How much error will be there, that will depend on the skill of the lover, type of the machine, type of the process, etc. So designer knows that error is to be there. He has to limit the error according to the velocity. So this is the error. Now, Suppose the gear which he has designed is having a size which is defined by the number of teeth and module. Module is one particular dimension that is known as module. Suppose module is 6 mm. Now you see that in your workshop, there can be three type of gears which can be produced. Precision gear, very low error. Careful gear, more error than precision gears, but reasonable. Commercial gears, highest error. You see this, you limit that it should not be no more than 0.064. Now you see that 0.64, it is almost a solution which can be used. So you can recommend that commercial cut gears will be used. This is very important decision. Suppose the error, maximum error here is 0.05. Now at the volume is 6 mm. You cannot recommend this, you will have to recommend this. Careful cut gears, the cost will increase. Now, I have discussed many parameters. You go back regarding the materials, quality of gear, the number of teeth, the pressure itself, how difficult it is. You can think of, I would say, that 50 alternative solutions are there. Then if I go back, spur gear, and then helical gear, 50 plus 50, 100 possible solutions are there. And out of that, I have waived for one particular constant or conditions of operation. One is optimum one, and the designer has to select the optimum one. You see how important the, you cannot develop a product, a cheap product. A product has been the requirement or need of the customer. Until and unless you are not able to think of the alternatives and take correct decisions. That's why if designer cannot design a correct design, optimized design, the product cannot be optimum one. This, you should keep this in mind. So the probable error must be always less than the maximum permissible error, and accordingly you will recommend to the production engineer that you have to make carefully cut gears or commercial gears can be used and like that. Okay, go to the next error. Now you have selected everything. Now you have to check it. I am the previous equation was giving the load, which identical load which is coming, which is not as broken to equation. Now dynamic load is to be taken care of by the gear tooth. Gear tooth has to take the dynamic load. So dynamic load is again based on so many parameters. Other parameters are same. This is stress concentration. Those who are very mechanical engineers, they know what's the effect of stress concentration. For other engineers, I give you a very simple example. You take a strip of paper, pull it. Can you predict where the crack will develop? No, you cannot predict. The crack can develop anywhere. But on this strip, you give a small cut somewhere and now pull it. You are 100% sure the crack will develop at the cut which we have provided. This is example of stress concentration. There is a stress concentration at the cut. So whenever change in cross section is there, whenever flows are there, when stresses are there, there is a possibility that stress concentration is there and a crack may develop there. So you have to take account of that stress concentration if you, by taking this vector KF, selecting this vector. Then sigma yield is known as endurance strength means fatigue strength. I told you that the gear is always subjected to fatigue stress. A pinion is running at 1500 RPM. It means the tooth is coming in contact with the, or coming in base 1500 times a minute. It comes in contact, disconnected, again comes in contact, disconnected. This is 1500 times a minute. Between 1500 cycles of loading are there. So your effective loading is there. And then if it is steel, medium carbonate steel or alloy steel, you can improve the fatigue strength by giving proper hardness. So a designer has to decide the hardness also. How much the material must be hardened. This work is of manufacturing engineer, production engineer. But designers should know how much hardness is required to give the proper strength to the material, to the tooth, so that it doesn't fail in fracture. So you will have to define BHR, mineral hardness number. Now, not only that, a designer should know that the material which he has selected, will it be able to be hardened to that number? Suppose you have taken medium carbon steel. And you want that BHS should be 500. No, it is not possible. You should know it. If you are not knowing it, you consult the production engineer that I have selected medium carbonation and why I want that RDF must be hybrid. Is it possible? He will say no, sir. You should not go for RDF greater than 400 and 350. So you will have to redesign. It is a very difficult decision how to improve the design. So if it is failing in the endurance, then the first step is that if BHN is say 250, you can improve the fatigue strength against crank by increasing the BHN. But there is limitation. BHN cannot be more than 400 if it is medium carbon steel. If it is alloy steel, you can go to 500. So according to the material, you can increase the BHN. But if BHN is already 400, this is not the solution. You go to the next. You can increase the variable B, but this is also giving small sense. So if you have to increase the strength slightly, you can change B. No, if it is not common, then use better quality gears. What is better quality gear? You have already selected that you will go for carefully cut gears. Now you find that it is failing, so you will go for precision gears. Remember that question is leadership. So this cannot be a final solution. You will have to think of another solution by increasing volume or by changing the quality of material. So, as I have said, that you will have the 50 alternative, you may have 50 alternative solutions. And out of those 50, what will be optimal? Then we are load capacity. I can see the surface fatigue is there. How surface fatigue appears? It is peaking on the surface or stretches of the surface. So if you do not take care of it, then there will be surface peaking or stretches. And you know that there is rubbing action in the gears where the base get up against surface each other. So if peaking or stretching is there, too much friction will be there and breathing will be there. The power will be lost in friction. So you have to take care of the surface durability, that is wear load capacity. And this is functional. Among the other parameters, the important is most one is the factor K, which is not the material combination factor, and which is functional along with the Young's modulus of elasticity, function of surface hardness. Now I am talking about surface hardness. The earlier one was core hardness. Suppose the tool thickness is 5 mm. The core hardness required is 350. And here you find out that to have sufficient strength, the surface hardness required is 400. Surface hardness means on the surface. We measure always surface hardness. So, production, you will specify the surface hardness. Along with you will say to the production engineer that for this material and this particular tooth size, I want that surface, when surface has 400 BHN, hardness, the core must have minimum 350 BHN. Now, the tooth thickness is such that, and material is such that, production engineer says that, sir, it is not possible. You have selected a material which is having poor hardability. So, surface hardness will be, we can give it 400, but the core hardness will not be more than 250 or 300. Your design has failed from production point of view. You will have to redesign it. You have to change the material, you have to increase the model, you have to change the quality of the gear. Yeah, coming to the last step and going back to the first step. This is design. Friends, you have seen how beautiful it is to discuss the design and design philosophy. Then, another important thing that gear pair, there is one pedial, another is gear. Pedial is smaller, gear is larger. Pedial is subjected to severe service, and gear is subjected to less severe service. So, chances of failure of the pedial is more than that of gear. So, you will have to specify that the pedial hardness must be more than the gear hardness. So there are certain modes in between where both pinion and gear are to be designed. That is fatigue factor. You will design the pinion as well as the gear. And so another alternative, another step is there. So yeah, you have the whole process is very time consuming. Now the alternatives are there. you will have to frequently interact with the production engineer. You will have to interact with the material science engineer, because you cannot be perfect. You don't know how much hardness when I give to the surface, what will be the point hardness. So whole interactive process is there, large number of representatives are there. You have to take large number of decisions, and greater the number of variables involved, more will be the number of alternatives you will have. And you see how beautiful, how interesting it is. Or in the end, I would say that whenever I teach design, I enjoy the maximum possible. उतना ही मजा आता है जितना अगर आपको शास्त्रीय संगीत में इंटरेस्ट है और आपको शास्त्रीय संगीत में बेस्ट कोई इंस्ट्रूमेंट को सुनते हैं किसी धुन को, कितना आनंद आता है, उतना ही आनंद डिजाइन करने बनाने में आता है. लेकिन डिजाइन करते वक्त आपके पसीने छूट जाते हैं, बिकॉज टू सी द ऑल्टरनेटिव, मेक द डिसीजन, क्रिएट द ऑल्टरनेटिव एंड सिलेक्ट द डिजाइन. A design which is the most optimal one based on your criteria, based on the selection criteria. So friends, I find that you must have found the whole design philosophy. I am trying to explain the design philosophy, and I have taken all material from my book. I give my email address at the in the second slide. So those who are mechanical engineers, they can always ask the questions to me by mailing me or my email address. I will have the greatest pleasure. Okay, thanks friends. I don't know how the internet was functioning, how much you were able to hear me. I have tried my desk, and I will invite now questions. There can be more questions than solutions. What I have presented here must have created more questions in your mind than the solutions which I have provided. I have not provided any solutions, remember. I have discussed only the possible alternatives, the design decisions you have to take out of those alternatives, and the alternative designs and how you can optimize it. Optimization for the cost, size, performance, the weight, etc. Okay? Any questions, friends? Rahul is there?
Yes, sir. I am there.
I don't know how the internet was running and how much you have been able to hear me.
It was there. थोड़ा सा आपका जो स्पीकर है सर उसका वॉल्यूम कम कीजिए. आपका जो स्पीकर है उससे थोड़ा सा इको आ रहा, बट इट वाज
रियली द लेक्चर इज ओवर एंड आई वुड इनवाइट द क्वेश्चंस इमीडिएटली और लेटर ऑन यू कैन मेल मी. ओके
या पार्टिसिपेंट्स में प्लीज आस्क योर क्वेश्चंस.
Okay, there are no questions. I would say Rahul, one thing that I feel that if you have been able to hear my lecture properly, then it will create more questions in your mind than the solutions. And I would ask the mechanical engineers especially, or those who are teaching the machine design, to ask me questions through email. I will have great pleasure to answer them.
Am I audible, sir?
Any query, and not only the subject, but if you have any difficulty in transfer, you can ask the, any questions to me. My email address is there, and usually many of the research scholars who are doing PhDs in MNIT. Or NIT, Delhi College of Engineering, Some of the students in the MBA business could be
checked. I think, sir, one of our participants want to ask the question. Yes, please. Is there somebody sir, want to ask the question?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Good morning, sir. Good morning. Sir. Sir, this is Dhiren from Bodha Institute of Technology. And
Mr. Dhirendra, just repeat your voice is like
okay, sir. Basically, I am in a lecture. So, sir, this is Dhirendra from Bodha Institute of Technology, Gorakhpur. And
okay, then you just give the PDF of my lecture.
Sir, I will give that PDF. But Dhirendra wants to ask a question.
Okay, okay, very nice.
Yes, sir. Please, sir. Dhirendra.
Yes, sir. Sir,
yes,
I am also from mechanical department from IIT Gorakhpur, and I have some question. Sir, as your last PPT showing that opinion is will be the stronger one, but a book that is R.S. Khurmi, you may know this R.S. Khurmi. It is given that if opinion and gear both made up of same material, then obvious opinion will be weaker one. But if pinion and gear both are from different material, then what will be the condition that is a Lewis of gives a condition that is form factor. By finding form factor, we will able to find out the value of the weaker, that is either pinion or the gear. So what will be your response regarding to that, sir? Hello, am I audible? हेलो
सर क्या सुन पाए आप
हेलो
हेलो
सर क्या आप कारवा सर का ईमेल आईडी क्या सेंड कर सकते हैं क्या आप क्योंकि मेरा
मैं आपको सेंड कर दूंगा मैं आपको सेंड कर दूंगा
क्योंकि मेरा मशीन डिजाइन तो सर से ज्यादा एक्सपीरियंस हम उनसे ले सकते हैं सर
श्योर श्योर डोंट वरी
कारवा सर प्लीज आप माइक अनम्यूट कीजिए हेलो प्रोफेसर करवा सर यू आर नॉट ऑडिबल प्लीज माइक अनम्यूट कीजिए
ओके सर प्लीज गिव मी सर
आई थिंक ही हैज म्यूटेड हिज माइक एंड वी आर नॉट एबल टू लिसन ओके आई जस्ट
धीरेंद्र सर
कॉल
हेलो
हेलो
हां धीरेंद्र सर
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I'm hearing your voice, sir. Can I repeat my question, sir?
Yes, yes, yes. I'm trying to give you an answer. On the, sir, when pinion gear are made up of same material, at that time, whatever the bending place and Lewis form factor, combine it and get the product of it, and whatever the lesser product, either pinion lesser or gear lesser, based on that lesser product, you
yes, sir.
हेलो हेलो
सर आपकी आवाज नहीं आ रही थी
सर इको हो रहा है सर थोड़ा आवाज
ओके ओके
सर थैंक यू इफ पॉसिबल प्लीज प्रोवाइड मी सर ईमेल आईडी आई विल डायरेक्टली मेल टू हिम एंड दो माय एरिया ऑफ रिसर्च आल्सो द मशीन
क्वेश्चंस ओके तो धीरेंद्र का तो उसको कह दो मेरे को या मोबाइल पे डिस्कस कर लेंगे और ये मेरे को ईमेल कर दो
ओके सर ओके सर
ओके सर
ओके सर थैंक यू सर
दिस वाज अ वैल्यूएबल सेशन
ओके थैंक यू
आई रिक्वेस्ट डॉक्टर राहुल
दास प्लीज फॉर द बेस्ट हियरिंग
प्रोफेसर करवा
ओके
ओके नाउ आई रिक्वेस्ट डॉक्टर राहुल दास चौधरी सर टू थैंक प्रोफेसर करवा दिस वैल्यूएबल सेशन It was very informative session.
Sound is not clear, sir.
Yeah, Professor Karwa has made very clear that providing that useful product in the ultimate is that ultimate function of an engineer. We have to really deliver the products, and which can be achieved with proper designing and optimization of the design. Rather, it is not wrong to say that prime function of that engineer is optimization. Optimization is very, very important, and that that is the very basic process to come out with the perfect design or perfect product, useful product. So Sir is always one of the best teacher I have seen, and he has been always very good in delivering his material, his knowledge. And today also we got a very informative session with him. Though I am from electronics and communication engineering background, and sir is from mechanical, but he is still so fascinating. And definitely these first two sessions would be focusing on more on mechanical part. Later on we'll be shifting to the design part or design thinking part, and then thereafter we'll be taking some information about electronics, IoT and all these things. So what I earlier said, that we have different areas to be discussed in this FDP, and we cannot leave. If I say that I have that electronics and communication background and I don't want to learn some mechanical concept or some aesthetic concepts or design thinking, we have to go through all these things, all these areas, then only we can really propose some very good products to the society. So be with us, be patient, and try to entertain this, and definitely we'll come out with some good learning out of this program. So we have to discontinue this session. I will share the PPTs and I'll share the Professor Karwa's number. He is such a good person. He always look for such type of questions, and he will be happy to interact with you. I'll share his email address also. So now we have to discontinue it, because within 10 minutes, within 6 minutes, we'll be starting our next second session. Today we had this inauguration session, and that's why we have to stretch up this first session program. So within 6 minutes, we would be starting that second session. Professor A.K. Sharma from IIT Roorkee is also known a big icon in this innovation and process product design. So he would be taking that session, and meet you in that second section. I would request you to log in with your second link so that we can start up that another session. Thank you very much. Thank you, participants. And thank you, Professor Karwa, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.